welcome. Today we're going to be scientists, and we're going to do that by exploring our stream. So what we are actually going to be looking for is something known as macroinvertebrates, which are the tiny little things that are big enough that they're not microscopic and need a microscope, but they're teeny tiny. So we're actually going to have to dig into the dirt, get a little dirty, have some fun, but we're going to see what we can find today and talk about it. So we've gotten some of the dirt off the bottom, so we're going to look around, see if we've got anything moving. So it's going to take a little bit of digging. We might not have it this time, but we can always go for another dip as well, and another scoop, and dig some more. But anything we pull out, we want to make sure we always put back in. So now we have a pretty good selection of things that we have found. So we're going to go over a little bit about each of our different finds here. All right, so first off, we actually found a couple of these friends. And I know that I said macroinvertebrates, so we're going to start with these guys, or these friends, because they actually are not macroinvertebrates. They are amphibians. These are a couple of newts, and they're amphibians, so they live both in the water and on land, and they like dark, wet areas, so under rocks, under logs as well. So here we have a couple of our macroinvertebrates. So this one is actually a stonefly. Some characteristics you can notice on him are his three pairs of legs, so six total, two tails, some antennae. He is a stonefly nymph, meaning he is going to turn into a stonefly at a later stage. So he will be flying around at a different stage. And then here we have a mayfly nymph. She is also going to be, since she is also a nymph, she is going to turn into a adult and fly out of the stream eventually as well. But some differences you'll notice, we still have the three pairs of legs, but she actually has three tails. And you'll also notice some differences in coloring as well. So the way we identify our macroinvertebrates is through our wonderful key here. So the way this works is it actually walks you through each step on identifying them so that you figure out what you've actually found. So you start at the top. The first characteristic it gives you is either a shell or no shell. So if it had a shell, you would come over here. If it didn't have a shell, it would be over here. And then you keep following that down. Legs or no legs, how many legs, wings or no wings, types of tails or number of tails, until you get to the end of whatever branch it leads you to, and that'll allow you to actually determine what it is. And then the color markings actually tell you how sensitive or tolerant they are to any pollutants and changes in the environment as well. So you can understand a little more about how resistant they are and tolerant.